Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will explain about how to customize the default editor window of the React scheduler. I hope everyone will be familiar with the default editor window that opens on double-clicking the scheduler cells or events. Now, I will show you how to customize this editor window, which is used for adding and editing the appointments with your own required fields based on the application need. Now, look at this online example, which shows a doctor's appointments listed out with its patients and shaded with specific color based on its status. When I double-click on this event, the editor window opens with 5 custom fields: summary, status, from date, to date, and reason. Here, this editor window is customized with the limited fields, so you can find different components like drop-down list and date-time pickers are placed inside it. So now, I'm going to design the custom editor window like this using my existing application. First, let me open my existing React application where I have added the React scheduler with simple JSON data. So, if you want to know how to create a React scheduler and add appointments to it, you can look on to my Getting Started video and I will also share its reference link in the description part below. Before I start to design the custom editor window, first, I need to install the drop-down list and datetime picker components package to my application. So, to install the drop-down list, I must use the command npm install @synfusion/ej2-react-dropdowns as well as I also need to install the datetime picker packages using the command npm install @synfusion/ej2-react-calendars. To start with the example, I have already installed these packages into my application. So, let me show you the code changes now. To start using the drop-down list and datetime picker components, I need to import the drop-down list component from Synfusion EJ2-React-Dropdowns package as well as datetime picker component from Synfusion EJ2-React-Calendars package. Okay, let me start to customize the editor window now by defining the editor template property to React scheduler. I will make a call to the template design function editor window template that receives the appointment related information as its argument. Then, I can make use of this information while designing the custom fields within the template design. Now, let me move on to the template design. I have planned to place 5 different fields inside the table layout and then add it to the template. So, first, I will define the subject field and set its label as summary. Also, I have assigned the text value subject to the name attribute of this input tag. Here, the name attribute is a mandatory step and its value should exactly match the appropriate mapper field name from the scheduler data source with same casing. So, I have assigned the subject field name from the data source. Along with this, I have also set the input type as text. Next, I will add another field to display status, so let me set its label as status. As I plan to list out 3 status options in this field, therefore, let me use the drop-down list component for the status field. And then, I will provide data source for drop-down list component by passing an array of strings namely new, requested, and confirmed. Also, I will define the placeholder property with appropriate value to display it as a placeholder text. And now, I have set the data name attribute and mapped with the status field name from data source. Here, I will access the status field from props and assign it to the value property to display this current item on the dropdown. Okay, let me move on to the next fields, which is the start time and end time. First, I will define and set the label from for this field and to for another field. For these 2 fields, I am going to use datetime picker component so that I can display and select the start and end time values from it. Let me define the data name attribute for both of these fields and map them with appropriate start time and end time field names. Then, I will access the values of these 2 fields from props and assign it to the value property. You can see here that I have assigned 2 kinds of values. When I double click on the cells, I can get the start time value through this variable start time and If I double click on the appointment, I can access the start time value through the start time field name, which is bound to the scheduler data source. Here, you can notice that I have additionally set the format property to specify the date time format to be displayed on the UI. Then, just like the start time field, I have defined the end time field also in the same way. Finally, let me define a description field with the label reason. And here, I have simply assigned the description field name to the name property of the text area. Also, for better look, I have added style attribute with some additional CSS to it. Okay, the editor window design is done. Now, let me tell you the mandatory steps to be followed while designing the editor window with the custom components. To all the custom components, I must set the class name eField. Also, make sure whether the appropriate appointment field names are mapped to this data name attribute. These two steps are the mandatory process while using custom editor window because the internal source processing is completely based on these class name eField and data name attributes. So, that's all about the required code snippet to design a customized editor window with the required fields. Look at the scheduler, and now I'm going to double click on the time slot 6 a.m. so that you can see the start time and end time fields showing the values 6 a.m. and 6:30 p.m. respectively. Also, I will set the summary text, status, and reason for the appointment now and simply save the appointment. You can notice the appointment getting added over here on the exact chosen time range. Now, when I double click on the appointment, you can notice the appointment values are directly getting filled onto the customized editor window. Additionally, let me show you now how to change the title of this editor window, which is new event by default, and also the save and cancel option button text. Here, you can display any custom text by passing the locale collection. To display custom text on scheduler, first I need to import the L10N class from Synfusion EJ2 base package, and then I need to make a call to the load function of L10N class within which I can access the locale words of the scheduler. So, for save button, I will provide the replacement text as add, for cancel button as close, for delete button as remove, and finally, for new event title as add event, which will be shown as the title of the editor window. Now, when I double click on the cell, you can notice that the new event title has been changed as an add event text, and the save button has been changed as add, and cancel button being showed as close. In the same way, when I double click on the appointment, you can see the delete button text is changed to remove. There are furthermore locale words you can assign to the text used on the scheduler component, which you can refer from the documentation page of React Scheduler, and I will share this link in the description part below. Finally, let me summarize some of the important points which we have discussed in this video. We have seen how to customize the editor window using custom template option, as well as we have seen how to change few locale words of the React Scheduler component. If you find this video as useful, then click the like button and subscribe to our channel too. Thank you once again for watching this video.